Hey guys, welcome back to Actraiser, the godly ginge here, Sir Alan Esquire, Escargot, let's go, down to Marana, Act 2. There was a lot of weird wordplay in that sentence, and I'm not necessarily sure what I was trying to say. Let's just get the level started, shall we? Let me get comfortable in this chair here as we prepare for an intense action scene. Really need a new chair, good god. Okay, what's going on? 100 seconds, oh Jesus. We can't go right, so let's go ahead and just press on to the left. Be a little bit careful here. I distinctly remember saying before that, like, enemies do 1 point of damage. Well, if I'm not mistaken, which I'm, like, 90% sure I'm not, enemies here are gonna start doing, like, 2 points of damage, at least certain enemies. These fucking faces in the wall are kind of annoying, but ultimately they're not too bad if you're patient, because you can just shoot their, or rather, stab their projectiles out of midair. I think these snake theaters do 2 damage. I seem to remember this level being a pain in my dick as a kid, and I'm not necessarily sure why. I guess we'll figure it out. Ah! What is that, a snake bird? Snakes and birds combined? Oh, Jesus. A recipe for pure nightmare fuel. So let's just carefully do a little bit of basic blah blah. I'm not saying that. We're gonna head on down, fight these death duders. What do they do? They just saunter in my general direction, apparently. I think they, like, shoot out scythes, as death enemies are wont to do in video games. Oh, watch out for the fireball. Yeah, it's actually a pretty smooth dodge. And let's get this treasure carefully. I don't know if those are instant deathery spikes or the damage spikes. I think it's the former. I think I need to get my stone statue ass up onto this platform. There we go. So what is gonna be up ahead? Let's go ahead and take a look. It's in a book. What do we have here? We have a platform over there. How do I get to the other side? I can't, like, jump off of enemies. Okay. Let's just head down, then. Not sure what's going on the left side. Can you get over there? I may have missed something earlier. Maybe there's an alternate route. Oh, well, I can't go to the right. This place does not like me going to the right. It's probably a big reason why I'm so very uncomfortable here, because it's very unnatural in a platformer, action platformer, to go left. I just don't feel comfortable at all. Oh, he shoots out little, like, blue energy, yin-yang things. Eh, fair enough. Okay. Oh, we're already at the boss. I did not see that coming. Alright, so the way you want to take this guy down, if you're not, you know, one to spam magic, is actually wait for these platforms to drop down, and then you can just ride it up, do a couple slashes, back off, rinse, repeat. He also has some attacks where he, like, shoots a laser ball at you, too. It's really weird. I've kind of got him stuck in a pattern here. Alright, there we go. Yeah, there's laser ball technique. And if I'm not mistaken, we can actually egg this asshole on to, like, smash down in us. Alright, cool. And you can get a lot of hits in that way, actually. I may implement that strategy right now. I'm not trying to spoil anything in the future. Yeah, so let's go ahead and see if I can't do that. Apparently, after he smashes into the ground, though, he likes to do, like, a little Fester's Quest curvy attack, so I guess you could watch out for that. I'm allotted 1 magic point here. Let's see how Stardust works. Hey, it did some minor damage. I can't complain about that. Okay. Whoa. Watch the platform, and maybe I can not finish him off. I was gonna try and do 2 slashes and a jump slash, and just fucking failed as hard as you could possibly fail. Oh my god. No damage? Alan, what's going on with you today, man? You feeling alright? No, not really. Just ate a whole thing of mac and cheese, and I'm feeling a little funky. I'm a good little white boy. Hey, Marana, Act 2 clear. Right in the middle, too. Man. Feels good, man. I gotta tell ya. So let's see all of these delicious, sexy, sexy points we're about to get. Holy mackerel. That was pretty awesome, I gotta say. And Marana is now totally clear. We have, like, what, 4 houses up right now? We've saved everyone, all the 42 people of this island. Sweet. It was difficult. Oh, we gotta grab the herb. I wasn't able to pick that up earlier, was I? Okay, okay. A man of eloquence appeared. He assured us that... Ooh, the devil appeared before them. That's kind of scary. They were deceived. Alright, fair enough. They've learned a lesson. Good. You learned your lesson. If you don't follow me, you're gonna get the lightning. You're gonna get the D. If you do follow me, well then, I'm probably just gonna drown you. So either way, you kind of lose. I'm just gonna be completely frank with you guys. So, we could farm up the population here. And we will do that in a moment. For now, though, I want to get cleared up in Sahasrala, or whatever the hell that desert area is. So let's go ahead and grab this herb. Cussandora, I know the actual name, viewers, trust me. And all the way back here, and we will see what happens when I use this thing. And there's actually a really cool little item that we can get here as well, so we're going to be picking that up. Let's go ahead and give these guys some delicious herb. Oh yeah. Are you guys gonna thank me or anything? Herbs just suddenly rained from the skies and literally cured all of our illnesses. But trust me, or rather, don't worry, we're not gonna praise you at all, Alan-sama. Piece of shit, citizens, I hate you all. Oh, okay, here we go. Sorry, I was getting really angry there. They found an ancient tablet. Ooh, yeah, that's gonna come in very handy. It says something about an island that has the same shape as the ground drawing. Have you seen an island? Is this Blue's Clues? Have you seen an island that looks like this bird? And also, make note, actually, of where that rock is. It's actually very important. For now, though, a little bit of movie magic because we have some population to build here. Just a sec, guys. I almost forgot to grab this tablet. Yeah, we had to take that with us. Let's go ahead and grab it. Yeah, you already told me about it is what it is. So, here we go. We got the tablet. Now, we play the waiting game. Awesome. Are we already done here? You got all this empty area, man. You didn't build anything at all. Seriously? I didn't even get a level up. It's kind of lame. Alright, are you sure? Yeah, they're totally sure. No one else is coming out. Alright, no more fucking in this desert area. Let's move on. We're gonna head back to the island with our stone tablet in hand. Yeah, you can already see the island on the northeast side here. Strangely, it looks like a bird. And also, I told you to make note of where that rock is. Well, you're actually going to want to use a lightning bolt where that rock was, which was right on the left side of the wing here. I guess it would be the right. I'm trying to think of relative to how the bird is facing. Is he facing down or is he... I'm thinking about this way too hard. Let's go ahead and use the stone tablet. There we go. And we will see what happens. There's already a boat, so I think this is going well. It probably... gotta be careful throwing stone tablets down from the sky there, God. Seriously. Bird-shaped island. So they're gonna go investigate. And also, we have a lot of construction that we need to do here. It's not gonna get, like, crazy populated, but it should be enough for a level. I can't remember the exact number that we were waiting for, though. Was it 29? It may have been 29. Anyways, just a moment, guys. Looks like they found something there on that little patch of land. Huzzah! Huzzah! What are they doing? Praise the sun! I don't know what they're saying. Alrighty, well, they're gonna head on back, and maybe they'll have a really fucking cool item in hand. Oh man, I'm excited. Come on now, take forever, I'm telling you. We've already got all the paths built and everything. This place is nice and small, I gotta say I like it. Alrighty. Yep, nothing going on up there either. Almost to our 2900 count, though, so we may very well get a level up. I guess we'll have to wait and see. Come on, come on! I didn't count how many people just came out of there. A lot of wheat fields growing, too. Pretty nice. They finally made it back to the temple, so let's see what the hell they brought back for me. Any day now. Maybe after this next population boost, which should get us to 2900? Let's see, how many are we gonna get? Oh yeah, we got a lot of people there. Hell yeah. These little houses house a lot of people, don't they? Alright, what's going on, guys? I know you're not gonna hold out on me, are you? My HP are 20 now. Wow, getting a lot. 3,300? Ugh, jeez. Seriously? What the fuck's wrong with you people? I'm gonna talk to you right now. Nah, they're just saying the ancient tablet spiel. I guess I have to wait a little bit longer. Boo, well, let's commence the waiting then. Hey, about time. I was about to just smite you all, because I know you're holding out on me. They discovered Master's Magic on the island northeast of here. Sweet. This magic, a lot of people stick with the Stardust magic. And rightfully so, honestly, Stardust is kind of broken for most bosses. However, I'm going to switch over to this one because, well, I don't really use Stardust that much, and I want to show off all the different magic types. So let's go ahead and pick it up and see what the hell it is. I actually can't remember which one this is. Oh, Aura. This is the one that I use the most, honestly, in the game. Even more than Stardust. I actually really like Aura. It's a fun little spell. Can I hold all these items? I have a lot of shit right now. What do we got here? Yeah, 3 strengths and 4 bombs. That's pretty sweet. I have changed my mind. Alrighty, so let's get this population up a little bit higher. Alrighty, we only got like 8 people with that last population gain, so if I'm not mistaken, this should be the end here of Marana. Let's go ahead and see. Hourglass. Oh, nope, we got one more little dude coming out. Alrighty. Fair enough, a little bit of a late bloomer there, but what can you do? So, Let's wait for the hourglass yet again. This place turned out alright. It looks pretty nice, I gotta say. A lot going on here in the middle area. Look at how big those temples are compared to the houses. Pretty goddamn big. Very nice. Very nice. And there we go. The hourglass has emptied. No one's come out of the temple, so we are officially done here. Let's go to the Sky Palace real quick and equip that other magic and take on our second action scene of the day, Magical Aura. Our body will be surrounded by balls of lights. Wow. Cool. An energy shield. It's not like an actual, like, shield, like a Mega Man shield. It just, that's what they call it. Alright, I clicked the wrong one. Sky Palace movement. We're gonna head over to Eitos again, a place that I think you're supposed to do before Mirana, but what can you do? And we'll fight some monsters, clear it out. This level is gonna be pretty badass. Eitos, of course, you can tell by that giant volcano there. Probably gonna have a lot of lava, a lot of dangerous shit. It's gonna be hellish, and I am super pumped. Let's go ahead and check it out, viewers. Oh yeah. Already looking pretty scary. I remember levels like bamboo. What the fuck, bamboo shoots? You wouldn't expect bamboo here, but alright, fair enough. And let's just head on down. Does bamboo grow by volcanoes? I don't know enough to argue against it, honestly. We're gonna ride this sweet-ass dove platform. Ooh, guys throwing stone balls at me. Not too happy about it. Get out of here! You son of a bitch, you almost hit me. Now, are there... Oh, fuck. I don't think there are items down here, and I think I need to hurry my dick up! That was very poor play on my part. We need to go ahead and try and stay on the platform. Don't go down and try and fight these little, again, natives. They're not really demons. They're just dwarves. Does God have something against midgets, man? Like, honestly? I'm not about to argue about it. Get these fucking birds out of my face. I know what... Whoa, what are you doing, Alan? Ooh, that takes two hits. I know we have birds helping us right now, but I like to think that they just leave me behind if I go down on a platform, so they are dicks as well. The safest way to do this is to just kind of sit here and take it, honestly. You can try and go down and try and dodge shit, but hopefully at this point of the game you have enough HP to just tank a few hits, because... A Tengu? The fuck is a Tengu doing here? This game's getting really weird, man. Ooh, check these clouds out, it's pretty nice. Fucking bird, get out of here. Also have these floating skull dudes. The only way they hit you is by just letting you run into them. It's a little awkward. They're so easy to take down. Here we go. We lost a life, but it's okay. We're just gonna press onwards here. Hands coming out of the ground, throwing more rocks at us. Ugh. You know, I could make a joke here about being a god and getting stoned, but I feel like that's incredibly inappropriate and shouldn't be brought up, so let's just move me away from the computer and microphone, because clearly I should not be talking. Alright, now let's move on up this mountain here. Yeesh. Tengu again. A little odd. I want to get over here to the other side, man. I bet you there's some sweet loot. I wish that was possible. I want to, like, hack the game so I can just fly, because there was also that platform in the last level I want to check out. I must be missing something. I think I'm about to miss something if I don't go over here to the left side. Yeah, what's going on? 1,000 points! An extra life amount, basically. So, makes up for the life I lost? Not really, because if I didn't lose that life, I would have still gained that 1,000 points. So, yeah, I'm just terrible. Where are we going now? Deeper into the volcano area? These guys shooting tornadoes at me. Seriously, weird enemies, man. I know it's like Japanese stuff. Is it Japanese? Like Asian mythology, the Tengu. Suddenly a waterfall? What the fuck is going on? But it seems kind of weird to just randomly appear in this game when there hasn't been anything like that. To my knowledge, there could have very well been. I should really just stop talking. I'm clearly ignorant to everything around me. We're gonna take this top platform. Careful now. And get the flame sword. This thing... Oh man, it's so cool. You shoot out lasers out of your sword, like so, and they do a lot of damage. We're gonna backtrack a little bit. We're just... Stupid bitch! I was safe too, I just got too freaked out. So embarrassing. Playing terribly today. Oh, and it was just a heal, okay. It would've been nice to pick up... Can I make this jump? Ooh. Would have been nice to pick up last time, you know, because I did need the health, but now I'm doing alright, so it's kind of pointless. I'm playing so goddamn bad, it's amazing. I'm actually glad that I'm recording this. It's more entertainment for you guys. And we get the flame sword again, laser shots! We were right at the boss, too, like, there was no reason to die there. And we just kind of want to... No! God damn it! Alrighty, we just want to grab a platform and just stick with it, basically. Just tank the hits if he grinds into you. For the love of fuck, I hate this boss so much. He always kills me, it never fails. Like, even when I'm playing, like, super well, I always seem to get knocked off into the pit at least some point in time. Oh, we have magical aura that I could proc at some point, like so. And as you can see, it does tremendous damage. It basically just repeatedly damages an enemy. They have to be relatively close to do that really big grinding effect, but yeah, super nice. In fact, I hate this boss so much that I'm gonna waste this magic and make sure that it's not effective on him. Yeah, that's the ticket. No, what I was gonna say is spam away, Alan. If you're playing like garbage today, you need all the help you can get. Good God. Hey, let's get in the middle. Yeah, sounds like a good idea. Eitos, Act 1 clear. Good. Jesus, I'm embarrassed to post this one. I hope you guys appreciate it. Oh well. 3 mediocre lives. Ooh, that is terrible. Score's pretty bad. Oh well. At least you still gain points, like when you start, you know, you play again, you can farm up enemies, but even then, I didn't kill that many enemies, so ended up losing points. Well, here we are in Eitos. We got some rocks to clear out, it looks like. Probably some volcano area. Let us work towards peace. What's going on, guys? Great plateau items, okay. Uncultivated, so he wants us to use lightning on the rocks. Begin to cultivate the land. Pretty straightforward stuff. As you can see, here's the map, probably a blue dragon spawning right there. And rocks and bushes. Yeah, pretty straightforward area. And an active volcano, great. Oh, new enemy type. These guys are just fucking horrible. What is it, 4 or 5, 6, I think it's like 8 arrows? Yeah, to take them down. And they do tremendous damage to the angel. I want to say like 4 or 6 bars. It hurts like the dickens if they touch you. Oi. Anyways, let's stop this mediocre video. As always, thank you so much for watching, viewers. And I will see you tomorrow. Have a great night.